fan of the show too.
They were begging to come on the show.
Hey, what Ghostface say about fans?
Never mind. What do you say?
Oh, shit, it's live.
Yep.
Welcome to episode 99.
Warren Sapp episode until I went to look at the actual careers, and now it's the Jason Taylor episode.
No, you said the Joy Taylor episode?
I'm not sure she ever wore 99.
She's 99 overall to me.
She wore at least 69. Anyway.
He's so fucking corny.
Shout out Earl Watson.
Oh, yeah, Earl, she was dating Earl Watson.
If Earl Watson could beat, I know I could knock that the fuck down. Jesus Christ.
So. That nigga was in the NBA and was on TV. Yeah, not man. That I'm saying that you aren't worthy.
He shared a locker room with Luke Ridnour. You never did, sir.
I did. That one time when we were at church camp, asthma camp.
Asthma camp? I forgot. Whoa, that's a highlight of the first 100 for sure.
Asthma camp. I wonder if they still have an asthma camp.
Absolutely.
That sounds like some early 2000 shit.
If Tyrell made it to the league, that would have been his like initiative, like his give back thing.
Oh, I for sure would have doubled down on asthma
camp. Yeah, I go back to my community. I run asthma camps.
Don't call it a community. It's just a bunch of niggas that can't breathe.
Like your community. Had one of these little old smoky moonshines?
I have.
They taste terrible. Just try it.
You got the like shot the shooter. It's crazy.
This was in a bridal party package that got sent to Brie. Oh,
that makes sense.
Yeah.
One of my friends, his partner bought him like the pack, and they come in like the full size mason jars.
Yeah.
Of different flavors. They got like peanut butter jelly, like smoked bacon, like a bunch of different crazy flavors.
It's very medicinal, I'm not gonna lie.
Tastes like medicine.
Yes.
I imagine the strawberry one probably tastes like NyQuil or some shit.
Yeah, the cherry flavor is good, but the alcohol portion of it is like intense.
Yeah.
Like very, very warm mouthfeel.
If you don't finish that shit like a man.
Shoot, bitch.
No, sir. I'm just debating taking NyQuil again tonight because my sinus hurt. Episode 99 of Critically Unfocused Podcast. Man, what's happening, man? This is a cold ass open, boy.
I said the episode, I said the show, all that stuff. I did all
you for sure did, man. And then we just fumbled and fell back into monotony, mundane. Nah,
salute, man.
Hey,
so Terry and Tyrell on Fortnite, man. My back hurt.
All I'm gonna say is I carried you niggas on Destiny and you had to return the favor on Fortnite.
It's fine. Y'all, that's debatable too. He was right there in respawn with us.
It's not.
Hey, man, shout out to you for playing first-person shooter games now, man. We couldn't get you to play first-person games for nothing.
Shout out to me on my first Fortnite game. Number one, Victory Royale. I got to see a W. That's all I'm going to say.
I got one real question for you, though.
What's up?
So why are you willing to experiment and play new kinds of video games for your work friends but not your other friends like me and Blake?
It's funny that you mentioned
that.
You
can't ask him that.
Because like I said when we were on the game today, I asked you niggas to play Destiny with me a year and a half ago, and you guys were like, man, you ain't going to play that shit. I'm not downloading that shit back on my game because you ain't never going to play. I was like, well, okay, I guess I won't play because I have nobody else to play with.
It's also not fair of you to ask him that, Jamal, when you still have not watched Evangelion, so.
I don't know what that is, but.
Yeah, see.
Yeah, Jamal. It's a bitch ass. No, yeah. I like to play stuff where I can just like turn my brain off and play the games. And Jamal, you even like solidified it too. Cause I got on today. I'm playing PvE, player versus everyone, if you're not into video games. And
Jamal, I thought it was player versus event.
I don't care what it
means. I guess it also works that way, yeah, but no, it's definitely player versus everyone.
I thought it was player versus everyone. But Jamal was like, man, I'm trying to get in the crucible. I'm trying to play against niggas. I don't want to play PvP first-person shooter games. I stink out loud. If it's not Overwatch, I can't play it. So I didn't want to play that.
Say it again. I guess, man. I just think men like welcome competition, but I get it.
Okay. But you said I started playing for my work friends, but it's funny because I played with you niggas half the day today. I didn't play with my work friends. I played with y'all niggas.
That's one day.
Pause.
Are you going to keep playing Destiny?
Hey, I'll stay on Destiny if Destiny is a way for us three to bond and play the game. I'll
fuck them niggas. I'm down. Let's get it.
All right.
But Fortnite is definitely more fun than Destiny.
Hey, speaking of friends falling apart, man, we got a touchdown in the wreck. And I'm telling you, this shit was like when Derrick Rose got hurt the first time, bro. Y'all don't know, Shakey Funny Ass is a staple of the IG comedy game right now. I feel like you may know him for the hit singles Off Them Drugs.
Off Them Motherfucking Drugs. I've been tripping off them drugs.
He got a lot of other ones that are like that, equally popping. You might have seen Shinbone too, who known for having like half his hair dyed blonde, the other half dyed black. A big, lanky, funny looking ass dude. They used to be like boys, I guess. Like I said this on an episode not that long ago. I watched an interview of Shinbone interviewing Shakey, and they were talking about like how
you talked about that last week.
Was that last week?
You talked about that interview last. Based on when we're recording this, you talked about that 4 days ago.
Yeah. Either way, Shakey was saying how Shinbone was always at his house and stuff like that. And they were just like, they were boys, like, and they're coming up doing the skits and stuff together and all that. Something happened. And there was quite the fallout. But basically, hold on. I'm gonna just play Clippington.
Bitch.
Him opening with bitch. Ass
motherfucker hater. Phone of you all under my motherfucking comments. Oh, he broke the blue check. What friend do that? Friend do that, boy? He say, chill, nigga. I've been chilling, nigga. I ain't chilling. Niggas be fake as hell out here, boy. Talking about cap. Phone them gray, you the same. Hey, Skinball, I ain't even gonna put you out there, gang. I'ma wait till you do some foul shit again, folks. On phone,
Hey, I was about to say, there's nothing. The Chicago accent is one that I didn't realize I loved as much as I do until I started playing video games with Chicago niggas, because it's like
they all get country. Mad the same way.
They all sound exactly the same when they get mad. It's very country, but also very like East Coast too. Like I thought Baltimore was my favorite accent, and then I thought New Orleans was my favorite accent, and then Baltimore. Chicago might be up there. That top three.
He didn't even get into his bag yet. Hold on.
Hey, I'm phone him grave, bitch.
Fuck you talking about? And I'll put 10,000 up, nigga. I'll put 10,000 up right now on my daughter. You ain't fucking with me, nigga.
He wanted to do a versus with skits and music with Skinbone.
All right, man.
Now he'd tear him up, though. Hold on. Okay, so one of his big gripes about this, like what happened was Shakey, he felt like people weren't like reciprocating help and stuff like that, and like knowledge and whatnot of how to like grow your brand and everything. But at the same time, people were definitely ripping off his ideas and skits and stuff like that and stuff that he was doing, particularly Shinbone, and like not giving him credit for it. And so it's not only like people are growing up off of his own ideas and comedy style and stuff like that, but they're not giving him back shine so he can help grow too. And Shakey figured out how to get a blue check. He said on here he paid $14.99 for the blue check. He flat out admitted it. He doesn't have a problem with that. But it's like, why are you in my comments telling people that like I paid for this check? Like
that is kind of wild.
That's a super hater move. Like
Shinbone is funny, but him and Shakey are like definitely a different like tier of like internet comedians.
And I was having this conversation with somebody else before this happened that like I felt like there's something weird going on because like Shinbone seems to be way better well off than Shakey just based on like what you see in the background of the videos. But I don't feel like Shinbone's nearly as funny as Shakey is. Like Shakey
Shinbone got a nice ass house, but he has no furniture. You've never seen a video where Shinbone
he just
has
the one big room with stuff on the wall.
Shinbone has never had a single couch, bed, ottoman, anything.
He got a poker table that they sit at and do the interviews.
Okay.
Yeah,
that might be the only piece of furniture in his house because I've seen his like TikTok videos. There's no furniture in any video he shows.
It's the content It'd be an
empty ass house. Shakey be in the house with the white fridge, but he's in the house that got a white fridge at least.
Yeah, we know Shakey has a kitchen.
Yeah, and a bed. I've seen his bed. I've seen his fridge. I've seen at least a chair.
There's a shower.
At minimum. Shower. Come on.
All right. By the way, yeah, I just felt like me personally, I don't find Shinbone as funny or entertaining as Shakey. But no. Like I said, it seemed like he's doing better. But it just may be one of them type of things where, like, that's just not what Shakey does. He maybe don't spend money that way. Yeah. But based on how this has been going on.
You've never seen Shinbone in a car.
Shakey, Mr. Economical, went out and got the RT, didn't get the scat pack. Don't need all that. But yeah, I like he's claiming like Shinbone's like been stealing ideas and skits from him. Shakey mentioned a bunch of other Chicago content creators like Corporate and I think Reggie Baby, who have told Shakey that, hey, you inspired me, like you definitely like, yo, like I did rip that idea from you because that skit was funny. Like I had to do it, bro. Like, and he didn't have no problem with that. But it's like this other dude is like just over here basically hating, and it's turned into this mess. And then Shinbone wanted to like post a video of like Shakey getting into a fight with Dontario Hudson. They just basically got in a shoving match, but
okay, I was about to say Dontario Hudson seemed like he fight for real too.
Yeah, he's like, don't play with me, folk. Don't play with me, folk. I got to
baby.
On baby. Hold on. I'm trying to find the one, because there's a video of Shakey.
I don't know how many people that listen to this show also listen to and watch Shinbone and Shakey.
They're probably not going to know who these people are.
You might not know a single face or a
single name. If you want to burst, then I have.
But please, go watch Shakey's videos, especially on TikTok, are hella funny. Where he'd be like getting beat up by his baby mom or his baby mom boyfriend come over. Those are always hella funny.
He's got them all on YouTube too. That's where
Shinbone is funny, but I can't think of like a single like specific video that he's done. That's like,
man, I'm trying to find. My fault. This is not a good content right here. What I'm doing.
That's the the GDs in the door video, dude. Right.
Yeah, they don't let the GDs in the dough.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. I was thinking like he looked
familiar. They don't let the GDs in the dough. I
damn. Yeah. Oh my god. Okay, this is the last one. I gotta find the one in the parking garage.
Hey Blake, go back to your search history. I got questions.
What was in there?
Nothing. Never mind.
Oh,
you stupid.
Yep. Here we go.
Guess what?
Go. That was him and Ontario. So him and Ontario almost got into a fight over $20, and that's what was recorded.
That's crazy. Ontario Hudson's a big nigga.
Look at Shakey.
What you on?
He's that mad, yeah.
Oh, is he on one knee crying?
So you started this shit, bro.
On the fourth.
What you on, man?
These are real GD tears.
Is he ever out and I'm down on one knee crying? Y'all better pick me up.
That was a caramel apple level moment. He said, need to be on my fucking side.
All right, hey, don't ever let me be down on one knee crying in a parking garage, dog. My shit echoing. My tears
is not proposing either.
My tears is echoing outside. I'm married. I'm not proposing. Pick me up.
That is on one knee crying over some beef.
That's crazy.
It's bad, though.
It's especially bad when the nigga that you're crying and yelling about is laughing at you.
Yeah.
Nah. Nah, King. I'm good.
We got to do better.
All right, what's next, man? My fault.
Not your fault.
Hey, who y'all think won the national championship tonight? Sets us on right now.
UConn, easy.
UConn,
probably UConn. Honestly, I'm gonna go with San Diego State just because it's more chaotic, and you know I like chaos.
I want that to happen too because it's chaotic. But I'm saying, like Sanogo has been unstoppable literally the whole tournament.
Wait, is Kevin Ollie still the UConn coach?
Hell no.
He hasn't been there in like 5 years.
Dude, he got fired. He won one though, didn't he?
No, I think he retired or something. Like he left immediately after he won.
That's not bad. I don't hate it.
Yeah,
he went and leave.
I don't even know who the coach is there.
He got a face.
If you can't tell, we're recording on a Monday night during the national championship of men's college basketball. But we don't want to talk about that. We need to talk about this women's college basketball.
Fuck Iowa. Fuck Caitlin Clark. Fuck that team.
That's rude. Mm-hmm.
Fuck the state.
Fuck sports gambling. That's 100%. Really why I'm saying all this.
How much money did you lose to be this mad?
$40.
$60, $70. Hey, that's still $70. I got to do with something else. Nigga. That's a video game.
Fuck you the whole. Bet money on it if it's going to hurt you that bad.
Fuck the whole state. Fuck everybody from there. Fuck that lady because I lost 25 minutes worth of work.
Bro, I fell for the hype, man. Like, she's been killing the whole time. She be talking her cash shit. I'm like, damn, man, she finna bring it home for real.
You know what's crazy? You know who else has been killing the whole time and who else has been talking their cash shit? Angel Reese.
Oh, yeah.
Her game log looks stupid as hell.
Honest to God, Jamal, I'm a little disappointed. You really bet against black women yesterday.
I know. Hey, man.
Like,
I know.
That's some nasty work.
I know. It's disgusting.
What would your sister say? What would your mom say?
Oh, man. I don't know. I don't think I'm welcomed that over my mama's house right now, honestly. If she found out, like, if you put those two teams next to each other, like, and roster by roster,
you bet on the white one?
Like, yo, you bet on that team? Yeah, she's not going for it.
I'm going to pull up this game log for Angel.
I can't wait till the next time I see. Your mom was in the Apple store not too long ago. I can't wait till the next time I see her.
I'm going to just be buying random shit, man.
I'm running up. I'm gonna be like, you know what your son did? He bet on white bitches.
Look at that's her. Crazy. No, this is way too far back. We need to go down here.
You pull up the Angel Reese stats?
This is her game log from her. This is not the most recent. This is a regular season game, ain't it? Oh, no, that's versus Iowa. Okay. It's just hard to see this without the
stats hard to read.
I'm getting dizzy.
Yeah, I'm gonna go to the ESPN one. My fault.
I didn't know she was the number two player coming out of her class, though. I didn't know anything about her until like this.
Angel Reese is
last 2 weeks. I didn't hear about her.
And she been talking that talk all season long.
I had no idea.
On it all season long.
I haven't seen any of the hate until just recently.
Well, because she's been hitting niggas with the... that makes sense. Yeah, you're not on Twitter. Twitter has been hating on her all season long, is what I should say. Which is niggas.
I didn't know there was like people like talking about them, like saying they had a cupcake schedule. I didn't know that's why they took the pictures with the cupcakes.
Nah, I didn't hear that either. But look, so 15-10 in the Natty. 15-10, 5-3 in the Natty. 24-12 game before that, 13-18 the game before that, with 2 blocks, 3 steals on top of that, 17-12 before that, 25-24
is crazy.
God damn, her game logs is crazy. Holy shit, that's some my player shit.
34-14, 22-11, 23-26 down here.
The fact that you just said 34-15 hella casually, that's crazy.
No, she was going
15-6. She must have been sleepy that.
And then look at her during during the SEC tournament. 23-26.
26-20. The Ole Miss.
25-16. 36-20. Her worst game during the month of February. 16-4.
Against the Leah Boston, number one pick.
Come on, man. Come on, man.
South Carolina, because that's all they had.
That's wild.
I know she was doing giving it to people like this the whole year.
Angel Reese is getting casual. Hey, Angel Reese has been getting busy, and she's been getting busy talking that fucking talk.
She don't shoot no threes either. It's all muscle.
No, she is JaVale McGee, basically.
Yeah, 23-15 this season. Oh my God, that's a monster.
That's crazy.
She's only a sophomore too, so she's definitely going to be back.
Yeah, I think because she went to Maryland, played a year there, broke her foot, and then I think it was COVID, so she had probably an
injury redshirt, COVID redshirt.
Yeah, so she's about to be the fucking 26-year-old senior type shit,
which I'll is perfectly it. Fine in the women's game because I mean I'll you got to come in and produce day one over there.
Hey, and her swag is incredible. Men can't do this, but the rolled up shorts with the long leg sleeve.
Faith, like, what? That's Jordan Poole.
It's not the same though.
That's Jordan Clarkson.
I don't want to say it. She got ass.
I mean,
Go ahead and say it, Blake. Go ahead and say it. Go ahead and say Jordan Poole got ass. So I can.
No, I'm just saying you're discriminating against Kyle Lowry now. So no, this is just.
That's facts. That's facts. I am discriminating against Jamal's older cousin.
Those ones are mine.
Fuck out of here. Future Hall of Famer Kyle Lowry.
All right. So Angel Reese.
It's fine. I'll go get it.
Angel Reese had Caitlin Clark in fucking hell during the national championship. Can you pull up Caitlin Clark?
Really, not really, bro.
But really. Because if anybody.
How is that possible when hell is 30 points? Like,
If you're hitting me with the John Cena, if you're hitting me with my own celebration, I'm in hell, is what I'm saying.
Okay.
If you're hitting me
from
with
that
the,
standpoint, yes, I get what you're saying.
She had a smooth
if you're hitting
30 ball.
Me with the bing, 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 like look at my finger, I want a ring in your
this
face.
Is who was in hell, the strong faced ass girl.
Oh,
nigga, and, somebody says she looked like somebody posted her side by side like Greg Oster tag.
Number 25 from Iowa was getting motherfucking cooked.
Nah, what a, she definitely like her daddy like, got a construction company.
She looked like she looked like her dad, honestly.
Oh my god, she been working on the railroad face ass.
I'm gonna take over the butcher shop with my dad die ass.
Oh, what are you having today, face ass?
Fam said she looked like Arvita Sabonis.
Damn,
she looked like a good rebound.
Wow,
they were cooking her the whole game, like not on the court, but on the court. But off the court, they were cooking her the whole game.
She's coming back too.
All right, yeah, pull up Caitlin Clark's game logs because she is also some shit. They did some work on that fucking profile picture. Hold up.
No, you know what it is? When her hair's up, it's bad. But
it's nasty out here.
Yeah, she like I'm telling you, like Roger from American Dad with the hair up. Bro.
30-2 with 8 assists in the natty, and caught a big ass red L. Crazy.
Oh yeah, little spanky. The refs 41. Also were being nasty that game to both teams. I'm not going to say that they did it in favor of LSU, but the refs were definitely trying to fuck that game up any way they could. 30-2, 41-6-8, 41-10-12. We can talk about it. Like the crop of women's basketball players coming out of college right now. Like what was left in the Elite Eight. Were you talking about like Caitlin Clark, Angel Reese, Haley Van Lith, Aaliyah Boston? Like, it's killers. Like, in the women's game coming up in this next crop right
now. It doesn't make any sense.
It's looking good for the WNBA. Honestly, like, as soon as they start, like, because I think another problem the WNBA might kind of have is like their players play a really long time. Since the rosters are so small as it is, it's kind of like. Constraining, I guess, like the game from growing a little bit.
Yeah.
But once this next batch gets in, it, like AZ Fudd, Paige Beakers, like all these girls who have just been killing it, playing basketball the way that like we see basketball played elsewhere. I think we got some exciting shit on the way, man.
Yeah. I know we talked about it last week, but like the it's like every year the crop of women basketball players that come out is so much better than the one before. Yep. Like, if you think about like Sabrina Ionescu,
yep,
yeah, the way people talk about fucking Paige Buchers compared to her is like a step above, and the way people talk about Caitlin Clark compared to Paige Buchers is a step above, and now like, you know, Angel Reese has that same talk, and then we think. Like what? 5 years ago, it was Breanna Stewart, and like,
oh yeah,
the step that these women are taking every single year in the college basketball game is so large that I hope and I feel like the WNBA will start catching up quicker, because I know they were talking about like the ratings for the women's basketball tournament
highest it's ever been,
and much higher than the men's game, because like we ain't really watching men's college basketball like that anymore.
Not regular
because
tourney time. Nah.
Yeah, exactly. And the tourney time is really because like we're looking for upsets, but we're not like locked in on like specific players anymore like that in men's college basketball. The
players don't stay long enough like that.
Yeah,
I feel like the rivalries don't mean as much.
That's when the game died for me. Is like one and done era, because nowadays like you don't have your Tyler Hansbroughs no more. You don't have like
guys that stay like 4 years and shit.
Yeah, just stay on him. Like
the guys who stay 4 years are ass. Like, not ass, but like I don't care to watch Armand Bacot.
Well, yeah, yeah. You don't have like anymore. Tim Duncan still in school, who's going to be like a number one pick if he chooses to come out that year. Not, mm-hmm. like, it's not type of shit. Yeah. If you stay in, like you hope you get picked in the first round the next year.
Yeah, yeah. But this probably women's not. Ball shit, they are cooking, and it's getting mm-hmm. better and better and better by the year. But women's college basketball might still be better than the WNBA to watch, just on like a competitive standpoint, because every like the skill gap is smaller in the WNBA, so it's not as fun to watch, but it's incredible to watch.
But a fun fact, the first so Kim Mulkey, who's the head coach of LSU, her first win as a head coach, like her first tournament win, like championship, was for Louisiana Tech. And that woman's Final Four was in Tacoma Dome.
Oh, wow. Did not know that.
Yep. I didn't know they had one out there.
1988. Goodness gracious. Kim Mulkey is my, like, least favorite person. She's a great basketball coach, but she's just, like, the antithesis of everything that's bad with the country. Like, you want kids to get paid? Fuck them. I love child slave labor. You want NIL deals? I hate that. Like, she's just anti-everything progressive.
And her fits be trash.
Nah, her fits are fire.
That shit she was wearing that last game, that shit was boof.
when she had the pink feathers on.
Have y'all ever seen her highlights as a player?
No. I'm sure they're great.
She was fucking cold.
I'm sure.
And their jerseys were like these sleeve shits.
Yeah. Nah. That's also why I hate her. She got the fire fits, contrary to what Jamal believes. She's a great hooper. But she's also like Donald Trump's daughter, basically.
She ain't that bad, bro.
She is.
Yeah, Cooper. I don't think so.
Okay, go watch some Kim Mulkey press conferences.
I've heard things. I remember when she said the thing about the COVID stuff. Like, hey, wouldn't it be great if we just stopped testing these players so they can all just play? This tournament just could keep going on. Which at the time, everyone was like, oh my God, how could you? They might die. But now it's like looking back, it's like, well, if they would have done that, it probably wouldn't have been a big deal.
Didn't you say COVID wasn't real?
Nah, he did.
And they got some big ass shirts.
Wait, is she hooping in a polo?
I'm saying, bro.
Those are like the NBA warm-up jackets.
That's different. She's hooping in a bowling shirt.
This is modern. Up in the you can't have your shoulders up in God's south.
Janice Lawrence looking inside.
Look at the one dribble through there, dime.
You guys see Jill Biden wants Iowa team to be at the White House with LSU when they go up there?
She did not say that.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Associated Press tweeted it not too long ago today.
Wait, what'd she say?
Not trying to get this real.
You know how like when whoever wins the college, they go up to the White House. Yeah, she wants Iowa to go up there too.
Does she not know how shit works?
I don't know. She's got to. She's been there.
Has she though? Has she?
I'm not one of those people that like hate participation trophies and stuff. But like, nah, just keep tradition. The winners go up there. The losers got to stay at the crib, man. You don't need to have the losers up there too. Because you don't think about it, like if they're gonna talk shit, like right there, they're definitely gonna be talking shit to them at the White House. If we beat you in the national championship and they just like, oh hey, we want you guys to feel good too, I'm definitely popping my shit at you when we go up there.
Yeah, that doesn't make any sense. I would too. Like, why are you like trying to share my day with me? This is not like,
definitely not. You didn't earn this. Be a bridesmaid, bitch, not the bride.
Well, come back next year. Like, what are you talking? Like, y'all made it to the Natty this year. Come back next year.
Hey. Oh, girl can hit the transfer portal, can't she?
Who? Kaylin Clark?
Kaylin Clark. Well, she hit the transfer portal. Hey, I'm just saying, what if she did?
She's about to get her PhD, dog. She's not going nowhere.
She's a junior.
She's still about to get her PhD. She's not going nowhere.
Well, she transferred to LSU. Let's run it up. She pulled a KD.
She might get jumped. Did y'all see the video of Iowa like doing their like pregame warm up like unity event?
Oh, the song they were playing and shit.
Yeah. they were doing like a High School Musical joint.
Yeah,
while fucking they're singing while LSU singing Set It Off.
The Boosie, yeah.
No.
If I'd have saw that video before I went to place my bets, I definitely wouldn't have did that shit.
Racist. I don't think she could transfer this because like she's such a staple out there. Like she's probably cleaning up in the NIL shit, like why leave? Like it's the same thing like Luka Garza, he could have left too, but like you was winning Wooden Awards out there making the tournament. Like
yeah.
Why leave?
Garza,
your money's on the way. You're getting paid now and your money's on the way.
Did Garza get drafted?
Yeah, Garza went to the Pistons. Oh, I think he's probably on their matter of fact, I don't think he's with the Pistons anymore. I think he's on another team.
I feel like he was with OKC the last time I looked.
Yeah, he was up and down, like on their roster from the G League and stuff last year.
That's the craziest part about like college sports to me, is that like, I guess it's really just basketball. That like you can be that, because Luka Garza was like breaking records. No one had any answer for him. Same thing with Tyler Hansbrough. Like nobody had any answer for that dude. And then they go to the NBA and it's like, maybe you can make the 15-man roster. Most likely you're in the G League.
If a team is bad enough and they want to give you the shots, I believe those dudes could put up numbers, but it's like at what cost? Because like we see it like with like teams like OKC or the Magic and stuff like that, where or even the Nets, like when they had that Cam Thompson dude who was like just dropping 40 out of nowhere like that. Like if they want to give you the looks, everybody in the NBA is talented enough to put up a game, but it's just like, bro, like at what cost?
Yeah,
the cost college white guy had me fooled. I thought he was gonna be like decent in the league.
Hold on, let me guess. What college did they go to?
Morrison.
Well, if I say it, it's going to be hella easy.
Okay. Morrison. Well, I feel like Adam Morrison's not the right one.
Fuck.
Because Adam Morrison had everybody fooled.
Was it BYU? Fredette?
Nah, I didn't think that shit would work.
Jimmer had me fucking fooled.
I was going to say, were you sure Steph Curry was going to work then? Because shit.
I wasn't really sold on Steph Curry like that. I thought he'd just be okay. Hermit at a Creighton. For some reason.
Doug McBuckets.
He's okay.
He's better in the league than I thought he would be. I thought the opposite of you, because he was working in college.
Yeah, he looked a lot bigger in college too. Because I swear he had like a back to the basket post up game and shit too.
Mm-hmm.
I thought Kyle Singler were gonna be cool. I'm not gonna lie.
Man, that makes sense. That makes sense.
Like you like KD, but a skeleton.
Hey, I'm about to play this this Andrew Reese video that people have been losing their fucking minds over. It has 20 million views on Twitter.
Damn.
I think I'm positive I know what your guys' thoughts are, but what are you guys' thoughts on Angel Reese?
And Angel Reese knows a ring.
I thought it was a bit much. Not going to lie to you. When I saw it at first, because she was like following her down.
In the Elite Eight, she had one of her teammates like Sharpie a ring onto her finger.
Oh, yeah.
Which is why she was pointing at her finger. And then obviously they won the natty. And then she hit her with the you can't see me 47 times.
I thought it was a bit much. Cause she's riding out for this like she was on Louisville. Like, come on, bro. You won.
It was a bit much.
Yeah. It was a bit much.
It was a bit much. That being said, I loved it.
Yeah, it's not like, oh my god, like Joe Buck, this what a disgusting act type of shit. But I was like, all right, like if that was anyone else who I guess gave a fuck, that's probably a scrummage. Hey, what you doing? Like, they got to start separating folks and all that shit. But apparently, like, no one on Iowa had any dog in them. It was like when we pulled up in Bowling Green, the fight in the line. Yep. a bunch of hearts like that.
Yep. Or even the Texas, like, she called her a bitch. You call me a bitch again, the bitch gonna come out.
No, they swarmed her.
Yeah. I feel like Louisville
hopped on that girl in the Texas line. I'm talking about the Bowling Green one.
Yeah.
No one did anything.
I feel like there's no happy medium for like the general public, because I know that like people do the like participation trophies are shitty, and like people need to learn to like, you know, buck up. Like, don't be a pussy. I think
that's a fake argument too, honestly. Because the people who were complaining about it, the ones that gave them to us. So it's like somebody said something at like CPAC or some shit, and it just spread from there.
Agreed.
There's nothing wrong with participation trophies, though.
Honestly. I've heard it for too long to say it's a going on
parade like you fucking won a tournament.
I've heard it for too long to say that it's a fake argument. I agree, because the
people, I think it's a boogeyman thing where people keep on saying it, but like nobody's actually mad about this.
Agreed.
People are being told they're supposed to be mad because it's a talking point. But as someone who received plenty of those shits, I play for Metro Parks. They didn't change my fucking life. It was just
I didn't care.
Mark,
you didn't put them in. You didn't like hang them up. You weren't.
You
like,
knew you were gonna get something. You tried to get the other trophies. Like,
we was at round table and they gave me that shit. Like, that's it.
Yeah. All that being said, I appreciated what Angel Reese did, and I want more of it. I want more of it in every sport on every level. Maybe not
rivalries.
Maybe not.
No, it's a time and place, man. That's it. That's all I'm saying.
I think that was the perfect time and place.
Yeah, hell yeah. I don't national think so. Championship?
No, I think if you look at like what like Austin Reeves and Pat Bev when they did the back to back like two small things after hitting the big shot, like in the midst of the game, perfectly fine. You just won and you're chasing the person down. That's a little crazy.
I mean, they had
like everybody's been there was still time on the clock. Telling them they're like the best thing on earth and they're known for popping their shit. So do it. You could do it back. I don't see the issue.
No, because it didn't happen between those two is what I'm saying. Like there wasn't anything between those two.
If they were fucking them up, she definitely would have been getting her shit off. You don't think so?
I don't know. Because I've probably watched four or five of her games at this point. And the thing against Louisville was the one that I saw that was like, okay, but like that Louisville is like they were popping shit. Like that was in response. So I don't know. It doesn't seem like she's that way all the time.
I don't think it matters necessarily to me. I do agree, Jamal, like Caitlin Clark might have been doing it. I also don't think it even matters that like, oh, if one would have done it, they would have done it. I just think like I just beat your fucking ass in front of everybody. I'm talking my shit, and I think that's okay.
I think, yeah, I definitely think she should have got her shit off though, but like that I'm just saying, like walking down this person to do that when your doubters were not like all within her. Like she's not the person who was like
who was
saying that you had no chance here and that you didn't matter in this game and that you weren't part of the show. That wasn't her. She just played her game and got her team there. Like so to go after her is stupid. Like when you really should be like looking at the crowd and like looking at the camera and getting into it, like think they're the ones who were fucking guiding you saying that you had no chance
in this game. I agree there too.
They were the ones saying you were playing against the triple double.
Caitlin Clark wasn't the one calling herself the best.
Y'all had her dance.
Yeah, Caitlin Clark wasn't like, I'm the best in the country.
While hasn't Angel said Reese a thing like that at all. Been humble as fuck. Hey.
Sucks to suck.
She did tell her bitch, you guys are down by like 15, shut up.
But they were.
Yeah, no,
they were talking.
And it's like, talking. Yo, we beat you guys in the national championship by like 15 points.
It's like, it's literally like when Steph Curry returns fire at somebody when they're talking to him. Like, it's that type of shit. It's not that he's going out of his way to do that shit, but like, what are you doing?
I don't think that's the corniest shit. Like how whenever Clay is losing, he always acts like he always does the four ring shit. Whenever they start losing any game,
nah, he only does that to the Grizzlies. He only does that to the Grizzlies.
He's done that more than once.
That's stupid.
Yeah, to the Grizzlies.
I've seen Draymond does that type of shit too. Like, I think that's stupid.
That shit.
I'm just saying, one complaint is just like that the shit was over. Y'all climb the fucking mountaintop. Do not let this person consume you. Celebrate. Talk
you gotta
shit to
piss
your haters,
off like the mountaintop same. Though, Blake.
Huh?
You gotta piss off the mountaintop.
You can't. Okay, remember when the Eagles won the Super Bowl and like how they were popping shit and they're in their at their parade and everything like that on the mic.
Mm-hmm.
That's how you piss off the mountaintop.
That's a good point.
Yeah,
that's a good point.
Or Aaron Donald when he got the sack on Joe Burrow and immediately goes to the fucking ring.
But there you go. The Aaron Donald did the same thing that
Reese didn't. No, who did he turn to? The fucking crowd to celebrate the moment.
Okay. You got a point.
He didn't chase down this one player like, you doubted it. Like, look what I did. I got it on you. Like,
hey, all I'm going to say is if they're saying you're that bitch and I prove to you that I'm that bitch, I'm running you down. You just got to hold that. So I understand. You do make very good points. Very, very good points, Blake. I'm proving to you that I'm that bitch.
And again, I don't want to sound like I'm anti-Age Reese. I'm absolutely not.
For sure.
Love it all. Baltimore. Yeah, love it. Narrative. We going up on a Tuesday.
And then let me play what, but to add some additional context to what she said, I'm going to play Angel Reese's press conference.
Oh, yeah. Hold it down, Shody. She tore it up right here.
Because she told y'all, if you got something to say, say it to your mama.
I'm happy. I mean, all year I was critiqued
about
who I was. The narrative, I don't fit the narrative. I don't fit in the box that y'all want me to be in. Yeah. I'm too hood. I'm too ghetto. Y'all told me that all year. When other people do it, y'all don't say nothing. So this was for the girls that look like me, that's going to speak up on what they believe in. It's unapologetically you. And that's what I did it for tonight. This was for the more. It was bigger than me tonight. It was bigger than me. Twitter is gonna go in a rage.
Amen.
And I mean, I'm happy. I feel like I've helped grow women's basketball this year. I'm super happy and excited. So I'm looking forward to celebrating in the next season.
If she was putting up them like 30 and 20 games this year as a sophomore, she's about to be fucking people up.
She's about to go crazy.
She might put a 40 or 30 on somebody.
Yeah, she's about to go fucking crazy the next couple of years.
When they play Mississippi Agriculture Technical College.
60 and 60. It's Mississippi A&T, nigga. Goddamn.
AT&T.
Agriculture and Technical College. Good Lord. But no, yeah, the women's game has, I think, over the last like 4 or 5 years, really taken a leap. What's Shorty's name that's on fucking ESPN all the time now?
Jeannie?
Yeah, she was the one that hit the shot for the Notre Dame, right? Blake.
Jeannie Ogumike, she's Notre Dame. I thought one of them.
One of Notre Dame.
Sorry, one went to Notre Dame and the other one went somewhere else.
One of them was USC. Went to Notre Dame, hit the game-winning shot, and is on TV all the time now. Mm-hmm. Like
and Monica McNutt's up there, too.
Yeah, really proving a point.
What's her name, like McNutt?
Monica
McNutt.
Oh, I said McNutts. That's a funny name.
Oh, my God.
Yes. But no, yeah, I feel like the women's game has taken a real leap over the last couple of years and is really, like, stamping it this year. Because this year's tournament has been so much greater, and I don't really care about the game that's going on right now, UConn versus San Diego State.
Almost raw. Bobby Lashley's throwing someone around backstage.
All right.
Oh, shit. Ooh, I was WrestleMania, Blake, since you
You popped in the live?
I was there for a little bit, then I went to go get some meat.
Oh, all right. Yeah. So night one was dope as hell. Damn, what was the big match from night one? Oh, the ladies got it in night one. That was Charlotte and Rhea Ripley. Woo, that shit was crazy.
Go Rhea.
They was going, man, yeah. Showcase of the Immortals, man. Snoop Dogg got on the ring, dropped the elbow drop on a motherfucker. Pat McAfee had a good showing. People's
elbow, he did.
The Dominic Mysterio, Rey Mysterio. That was a good match, too. Really good match. Yeah, I can't complain. Omos and Brock Lesnar kicked off night two. That shit was nuts. Those are some strong ass motherfuckers right there. Brock Lesnar.
How big is that almost, dude?
I want to say this, and I'm just saying this without looking. I think like 7'4", 400 pounds. Like he's huge.
I was like, he's got to be 7 feet. He looks.
He's like scary big. They was like doing yeah. Brock Lesnar hit him with like I think four like German suplexes in a row, and that shit was nuts. Seeing someone that big get tossed in the air. Braun Strowman had a good showing on night one too. And like I think it was a multi-man tag match. He's like running around the ring, doing his like freight train shit, knocking people over. That was cool. I don't know. Yeah, it was good overall though. Bianca Belair, tremendous match with Asuka.
Who won that?
Bianca Belair. That was dope. Usos versus Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens was crazy. That was nuts. A lot of moments where, like, there ain't no way he tapped out of that or he kicked out of that and shit. But, yeah, it was good.
I kept seeing that over and over last night. Not watching this, people talking about the kickouts at, like, 2.99999999 seconds happening.
All right. Yeah, there was a lot of that. And I think a lot of, like, slow kicks from the wrestlers when they were supposed to kick out faster. But yeah, overall, I mean, I can't complain. I love what they did, like moving to Peacock and like just letting you have a Peacock subscription to watch the pay per views.
That's pretty
way better than like paying for it. But I guess it's the same thing as like what it was when it was the network. But now you get more stuff with it too. But yeah, I think they're in a good place. And obviously, the big news over the weekend was that they sold to Endeavor, who's the parent company of the UFC. So now they're going to be managed under one umbrella. So that should be some interesting crossovers because they've done a lot of stuff now with like getting like real media backstage at big wrestling events and having them do interviews with the wrestlers when they aren't in character to actually talk about like how that night went for them and everything.
Yeah.
So I think now we'll probably have, I don't know, just more of that. And you get to see like more of the personality. I saw a really good one with Ariel Helwani, who's like big in the MMA world.
He was talking to
Ripley backstage after her match, and she was just talking about how emotional that weekend was for her and everything. which you're not going to get from her, which she's in the character of like mommy, because that's not how mommy talks. So, yeah, I don't know. It's cool.
I see Stephen A up there too.
I don't want Stephen A was up there for free show. Yep.
UFC and WWE being under the same umbrella. Do you guys think that has any impact on like UFC like guys after they're done in their prime moving over to WWE, or like any impact on like how it's promoted? Oh,
shit. I didn't like, think of that.
It should definitely help out with talent scouting, because there is there's a lot of guys who like guys and girls who can't get off of like the pre-show cards and shit like that, and it's like, damn, like, well, I don't have this going for me, but like I'm in tremendous shape. I'm young. I'm athletic. Yeah. And I can do something. Maybe I got microphone skills, and like they're just not showing up here because I don't have the chance yet. So I'm gonna spend the summer at the Performance Center and see if I can't do this wrestling thing. It's probably a lot easier to make that happen now, and you're probably gonna have more eyes on you for that now too. Like Shayna Baszler, she wasn't doing shit in MMA, but she was Ronda Rousey's friend. And I think she actually went to wrestling before Ronda Rousey did, and now that's worked out well for her. So there's probably just more stuff like that.
I didn't even think of that, but that definitely helps with that crossover. Like, if you can't make it here, you can come fuck with this.
Mm-hmm.
Because they definitely got the ability already, so.
Well, yeah, I mean, and, you would think just because it's more money in for everybody, I would hope the WWE, like, kind of can help the MMA people brand themselves and like start selling themselves a bit more too. Like they probably could help out with that, because
WWE folks are
all good at that.
Damn, how much did that go for? What, 21 billion?
That was a big number. I don't remember.
I
think they said 2.1 billion or something like that, right?
I think it was 21 billion.
God damn. No, it wasn't 21 billion.
I'm telling you, bro. Right. Dude, look it up. Why would I make this up?
Because I'm not saying you're making it up, but 21 billion and 2.1 billion look the same.
That's never wrong, bro.
Well, hold on. It was 21.4 billion.
Yeah, man. That's a lot of money.
That's hella fucking money. That doesn't make any sense.
How much was 21?
21.4 billion.
What percentage of it sold? Was it all of it?
Don't know. No. Taking a 51% controlling interest.
So they didn't even get the whole company for 21.
They got the majority.
51%.
$21 billion that means fucking stupid.
It's a $42 billion industry.
Nah. None of this makes any sense. I don't like any of this. Holy shit.
Wow.
Hey,
someone got supposed to buy the Washington Commanders for... Like,
if I see Dana White in public, I'm putting the blicky to his back. I'm robbing him. I know he don't got all that, but I'm robbing him.
He's going to put you in the slap league.
Me and his wife will be in the same place. That's fine.
Oh, Lord.
I forget that even happened. They didn't even – I'm really surprised ESPN didn't, like, bring that up or talk about that at all. Because I know they were kind of catching –
They did when it happened.
Oh, did they? I feel like they
– Yeah.
That shit kind of just came and went, I feel like.
There was nothing they could do about it after that. I mean, like, shit, like, if she didn't press charges and she can't get fired from his company. It's his company. Like,
all right. let's talk about the wildest. I don't think I've ever seen a Friday night news dump like the Friday night we just had for the NBA. So the CBA was like ratified, or they voted on the CBA, and we got a bunch of new news, which seemed like it just kind of came and went because it was on a Friday night. So the NBA changed the starting with like the mid-level exception. If you're over the cap, there's a second salary cap. So it says the league is implementing a second salary cap apron. $17.5 million over the tax line. Those teams won't be able to do any of the like team building assets that they have now. So there's no mid-level exception. They can't do any like four cash trades. They can't move first round picks in later drafts or drafts that are 7 years away. And they can't sign free agents that are in the buyout market.
This is supposed to stop teams like the Warriors, Clippers,
and shit like that that just live over the cap and they're constantly like playing around with not having any money.
Yeah.
Like, you gotta get your books together.
It says, under these changes, Dante DiVincenzo, Joe Ingles, Danilo Gallinari, Patty Mills, John Wall wouldn't have been able to be signed by the teams they were signed by. And then mid-season trades like Norm Powell and Robert Covington also wouldn't have been able to happen this year.
You know who submitted this rule?
The Clippers.
Ooh,
no. Tyrell's broadcast team. Can't afford to play around with the new money people like that.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Our business is basketball.
Then they said, so for the, they're trying to get rid of load management. So it's a mandatory 65 games played to be on all NBA teams, or like the MVP. So any awards, you have to play 65 games.
Yeah.
Any major award,
you have to play 65 games. I do like that. That's a good number.
Yeah, 65 doesn't seem crazy. You know,
I'd go 67 maybe. It was a little closer to 70, but 65 is fine.
The wildest change, and it seems like people are like glazing over it the most, is the in-season tournament. So starting like as soon as next year, there will be an in-season tournament. The event will include pool play games baked into the regular season schedule starting in November, with 8 teams advancing to a single elimination tournament in December. The final four will be held at a neutral site with Las Vegas prominent in the discussion, sources said. But there's going to be like a whole ass, like, March Madness style tournament in the middle.
Yeah, I mean, well, so it's 8 teams advancing to a single. So,
but it's still every
that'll be over fast, though. I mean, honestly, this sounds like a second All Star weekend.
But it's not the weekend, though. It starts in November.
No, the 8 teams advancing to a single elimination tournament in December. So, single elimination. With 8 cool. teams, that means that's what? That's 4 games?
Well, no. It's saying the event will include pool play games baked into the schedule starting in November with 8 teams advancing.
That's what I'm saying.
They got to start with at least 16.
I know, but like those are just going to seem like regular season games. I'm talking about when it gets to the 8 teams advancing, you're talking about like a second All-Star weekend, basically.
Oh, yeah. I see what you mean.
Yeah, so... And that could be over fast because 8 teams, that's 4 on each side, which means what? Yeah.
It, 7 nights at the most, like a week at the most for the like end of it.
So that, yeah, I mean, it's a dope idea. I mean, honestly, you got to talk. I think the prize is just money for the players.
Yeah, they said it's $500,000 per player, which Draymond got on Twitter. Nothing. Draymond got on Twitter and said that he was upset because they had initially discussed $1 million per player and they lost out because it got to 500K per player. Which, I mean, obviously it doesn't sound like they're adding extra games. I know I've seen people saying that, like, if you make it to the finals, you're playing like 102 games or something like that, but it doesn't sound like based off this they're making or playing any extra games. But I'm very interested to see how this will play out and like how it'll be received. Because if it starts in November, like November is what, a month into the season?
So yeah, like, I think there's an easy way to flex this where you have the teams that aren't in the tournament. Maybe they pick up an extra game against each other. So you're supposed to only play like if you're a Western Conference team, you're supposed to play an Eastern Conference team only 2 times. But maybe you end up playing them 3 because y'all are both are not in the tournament or whatever.
Very interested to see how that works out.
I honestly wanted them to do something with the lotto teams. I thought that they were going to do like a tournament there where the winning team ends up getting like the first pick. I thought that could have been cool, but
yeah. Oh, it does say that if you end up essentially if you make it to the final of the in-season tournament, you play an 83rd game. So there would be 1 additional game played if you make it to the final of that in-season tournament.
Okay.
Which I'll say, like, the play-in tournament's been fucking dope. And
they should this tournament, I think what would be like really cool and a great incentive would be like an automatic at least bid into the play-in at the end of the regular season. Like, so let's say like things go absolutely terrible for y'all the rest of the year.
You lose
at a minimum you're in the play-in.
That's not a bad idea, honestly. Yeah. Like if your star gets injured. Like if you're the Grizzlies and like Ja gets injured, so you end up like losing out the rest of the season, but you won the midseason tournament. which mm-hmm. happened in December, like you just make it in. I'm not mad at that. And then it says the NBA and the NBAPA have agreed to increase the upper limits on extensions from 120% to 140%, which could have a significant impact of the future stars like Celtics forward Jaylen Brown. So essentially, you can offer more in, like, not the max contract, but like you can offer more during contract extensions.
Leads to the shit though, the all NBA teams.
That's what I'm curious about.
They got rid of all the, it's positionless now. So was like the big thing of like how I think DeAndre Jordan made like an all NBA team and shit. Because they had to put centers on there. People feel like they're caved on this rule just because they weren't allowing like Embiid to make first team all NBA next to Jokic and shit like that. And now this will let that happen. It's a little fucky because it's one of the lines in the sand sort of where there's a before and after now. Because there's a lot of players in the past who basically weren't able to make these teams because of that. I don't know. It doesn't affect me in any way. I get the complaints though from players that are talking about that, like, yo, you're fucking up history here a little bit.
Yeah, low key.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It does. I'm reading through some of this. I haven't read all of it before now. Teams can trade for a third Supermax player, which was prohibited before now. Or you can sign, if you have two Supermax players now, you can sign a third Supermax player. So the example they used was like the Cleveland Cavaliers having Donovan Mitchell, who's a Supermax player. And then they're going to designate Darius Garland and Evan Mobley as Supermax players after his rookie extension's up. So that's adding additional money, which is nice.
It's a lot of people keep their stars.
Yeah, which is ideal. And you can keep your stars and trade for additional stars, which you couldn't before. That doesn't matter for the moment. Yeah, none of this other shit matters outside of what you guys said. Yeah, I've seen Draymond is the main person I see online, like, talking about how they got hoed over, though. So I'm interested to see
just how, the $1 million like, thing.
Well, he talked about that and just like we went to the table and lost. He said they lost on every point, which it's hard to say, like, if you're not listening to what they were asking for to say whether or not they lost.
But bargain better, lost, bitch. On every point.
Come on, Kyrie. Do better.
Is he still the rep, the president?
There's
of the
a players? Lot of them. There's multiple of those apparently.
I think they're vice president. Okay. Yeah, I think they got a bunch of
vice presidents. I know CJ McCollum's a part of it too.
Yeah.
The bet I was talking about though earlier, now because we're talking about NBA, I saw today on I think it was Fox Sports 1, the Lakers are plus 3,300 to win the title, and I would
put money on that.
Plus 3,300.
Yes.
I might go put money on that. That's crazy.
Yeah. They're playing good basketball. And if the only problem with them is that you cannot count on Anthony Ron Davis to be there for like 7 of 10 games. So Blake LeBron is getting to that point now too himself.
You said they're doing what, Blake?
Huh?
What are they doing? You said they're doing what? The Lakers are doing
you can't. Oh, I would put money on them to win the title. Yeah, they're playing good basketball. They're playing good basketball.
Oh, good basketball. Okay. Like to hear that.
When everybody's on the floor together, that's a good team, man. Y'all, that trade was money.
Cash fucking money. Holy crap.
Yeah, they did their fucking thing on that trade.
I guess, if you just want to throw $50 on it, that's what? $1,600 right there.
I'm saying.
Put $100 on it. Shoot $100, nigga. Bet $100.
Oh, I'm not.
What's it say?
The Lakers are at the 7 seed right now. They played the Jazz twice. They played the Suns and the Clippers. If the Lakers went out, they're the 5 seed. Or sorry, if the Lakers went out, they could be the 4 seed.
Yep.
Which is crazy.
All those teams are hella close. So there's 338 lost teams. So the Lakers with what? One more. If they take the Warriors spot, they could get the Kings. And I do not think they would be tripping about that.
Come on.
Sorry, Jamal, respectfully. Like the team and all that. But goddamn.
The Kings play no defense. They just let the Spurs drop like 150 on them the other day.
That's a tough matchup for the Kings. Like having LeBron and AD come in, The biggest gripe will be whether or not AD can stay healthy. Like, I feel like LeBron's set for the rest of the season. He took his little 2 months off. It's whether or not AD can stay healthy.
I think AD dropped like a smooth 40 last night or something, like easy 40.
Yep. Against the Rockets?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Cooked them up. I mean, beat them by 20.
It was the Rockets, but...
Hey, yeah, the Rockets beat us 2 weeks ago.
Because y'all didn't play AD or Bron that game.
They beat us 2 weeks ago. Yeah, they still did. And then you look at the East. Hey man, the Knicks are the 5 seed. What you see, Blake? What's going on?
I think Julius Randle wins his first playoff game.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
What do you mean? They got swept by the Hawks?
Yes.
I thought it was 4-1. I didn't know they got swept.
Did you?
No, dead ass. I put that on everything I love. I thought it was 4-1.
I feel like you guys recorded every episode. I remember I was in Mexico while you guys did that, those series of shows. I think you guys recorded every fucking game.
Yeah, man.
Honestly, though, if we're keeping it in the buck, and I love you. I love you, Blake. The Cavaliers might sweep you.
It's not looking good.
The Cavaliers are not the team you want to play. You might want to go ahead and drop down to the 6th seed and go ahead and play the 76ers.
Why are the Nets at the 6th seed?
It's crazy.
They were like,
what the fuck is going on?
The Nets have no desire to be in the playoffs.
None. They should have fallen off like the Mavericks did.
Yeah. Well, one of those teams have Ben Simmons, so.
No, the Mavericks give up like 130 points a game. They are fucking trash.
Yeah, if I'm not mistaken, I think the Mavs are out of the play-in right now.
No, I think
the Mavs are the 11 seed.
Yeah, man. They traded away everything for a fucking rental that can't play defense.
Yeah, the Mavs are one loss away from like not being able to get in.
They're about to piss the Jazz off and like end up putting the Jazz over them. Jazz, like, what the fuck are you doing?
If the Mavs get Victor Wembanyama,
do they have the pick?
I don't know. Top 10
protected.
Probably not.
We have a pick from them.
Yeah, it's top 10.
So protected. Yeah, they got to be in the top 10 in order to get the pick. If not, it's our pick.
They'd have to be the one.
That's why they're talking about maybe shutting down Luka and Kyrie.
They better. But I don't think Kyrie's not coming back if they do that. Which I don't know. Maybe that's what they want. I don't know.
That's crazy.
Do you think what's the chance y'all think Kyrie leaves? I think it's 50-50.
Honestly. I just don't know.
I think it's higher than 50-50.
I don't know where he lands at that point. Like where is the we want Kyrie city?
That's funny.
That's about it.
The Lakers will pay Kyrie, I promise you.
Lakers
like D'Lo.
I personally am not a huge fan of him being on the team. I promise you the Lakers will pay Kyrie.
I think Miami would too if they could make their books work, but they got a lot of money tied up.
Any of those teams that are cocky enough to think that they can like fix any player, the Lakers are one of them. They'll pick Kyrie up. I want to know.
Just make it not matter.
I do want to know what's about to happen here at the 13th seed in the West. Damian Lillard got to go soon.
Like, I'll tell you what's not about to happen.
Go ahead.
They're not running from the grind.
Dame's got to go. At some point, if not for, like, Dame's ego, he's got to go for, like, the team.
No, that whole situation is a fucking mistake.
Dame has probably won. They have 33 wins. Dame's probably won them 27 games.
God bless the dead, but Paul Allen dying was, like, the worst thing that could happen to that franchise. They lashed on the Dame, like, for dear fucking life. And, like, here, take it all.
Yeah.
I can pay him the most, man. I get why he's not leaving.
I get why he's not leaving. From a competitive standpoint, though, it's a terrible decision of the franchise. Not to say Dame's a bad player, but there is probably like 4 players in NBA history that can occupy that much of your salary cap and keep you winning games. And he's not.
No, I'm going to be real. He might be one of them, but the rest of your roster is not good.
He's not, because there's another guy who plays his position who we all say is the reason that Dame isn't looked at as like the best 3-point shooting guard of all time. And he's still active in the league.
He is 6 feet higher. That's fact. Yeah. No. And that's to that point. If Dame had Klay Thompson, if Dame had Draymond, Like if Dame dreaming, had the same
Draymond Green.
I don't know why I said Draymond.
I was wondering why you said it like that.
Saying Draymond is crazy. If Draymond. Dame had the same like roster around him, I feel like he would be 7, 5, 8, like somewhere in that area still right now.
I still don't know. Yeah. And that's again, like no knock to Dame. I fully recognize how incredible he is. Steph is some bullshit. Like
Dame averaged 32 points a game this season.
Dame's fucking hooping. They're talking about he still might make all NBA. Behind.
Look at his team though.
Yeah.
It's all some shit.
Yeah. Dame averaged 32 points a game this season.
He's got to play 105% for them to be the 12th.
He averaged 32-7-5.
Yeah.
That's fucking dumb.
He's nice, man. That team just stinks.
Yeah, that's
damn Beaverton on three.
That's a career high. Dame had the best season of his fucking career this year. And they're at Loma Valley on three. Oh my God. That's hard. That's tough. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Dame needs to leave like yesterday. He should have left 2-3 years ago. He should have left before CJ left.
It's only going to get progressively harder from here on out as his cap number goes up. Because you're going to ask a team to trade a whole fucking boatload in order to make that fit if they want to trade him out of there.
That's true. He's probably going to be there, honestly.
Yeah. Or he ends up, like, I could see him going to the Heat just because they do have a lot of money tied up in people who maybe they don't see themselves winning with for the long term.
Oh my God.
And he seems like a player that would fit them perfectly. Like, him and Jimmy seem like they would get on tremendously. You figure
Dame is gonna
you can somehow keep him, Jimmy, and Bam. That's a good ass three.
Dame is making $39 million this year, $42 million next year, $45 million, and then $48 million.
Yep. So holy you figure shit. Like if you're the Heat, like let's say like you trade Lowry, Duncan Robinson, Yurt Severin, and they have one other like the like good potential young dude, and I don't know what picks they have, but you probably got to give them all the picks.
Yeah, all of them. Yeah.
But then now you have like, yeah, so like a young core of, ooh, or not a young core, a core of Dame, Jimmy, and Bam.
That is a good ass three. With Hero too? Yeah. Probably Hero too?
I was going to say, go ahead and throw Tyler Hero in there because Tyler Hero
might have to take Tyler
Hero. Yeah, because yeah, the money for sure.
Yeah. By the way, that's still a good three. So with that three, you probably got like a good 2-3 year window to make something shake. God, damn. So yeah, what's that down there? So his new extension ain't kicked in yet, because that's the number I'm thinking of. That's 62? 61? Yeah!
That's the projection. That's not real. That's it.
Like, this is an upcoming contract extension.
Yeah, they're saying like when he's eligible in 2025.
So he hasn't signed that?
They're expecting that he would get $58 million dollars a year.
When did he sign this one? Because I thought he had a $60 million a year already on the books, like just locked in.
He signed, it said he signed a 4-year, 176 in 2022.
Okay, 2025 free agent.
Yeah, so he's not a free agent until 2024, 2025.
Oh, yeah, no, no way.
And that's a player option. So he's not a free agent until 25, basically.
Oh.
He's not turning down $48 million.
Okay.
So 25, he's projected 58 if they were to extend him.
Has anyone signed this extension yet then? Does Steph have that extension?
I mean, him and Steph are the same age.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's based on how long you've been in the league. So has anyone signed that one yet? With the
I guess that would be Chris Paul, because Chris Paul was the reason that they changed the, like, extension you could sign at 35-plus
years old. Yeah, Chris Paul don't have that many years left.
Yeah. So this is because at the end of his deal, he'd be 35 years old. So this is the Chris Paul extension, and it would be.
Go to Steph Curry's page. See how much, because I know he just re-upped, I thought.
He got a crazy deal. I know that for sure.
Yeah. Wardell.
Wardell.
They're a
not PGA him, not him having a fucking golf contract.
Dude. Oh, that's the same person. Oh, wow.
So Steph
so is he signed, has a 59 on the books.
He signed through 25, and that would be the last year for Dame.
Yeah.
And that's 36. He's 3 years older than Dame.
Oh, my God. Oh. Yeah, no, that's not going to work out either.
Steph is going to make 48 this
holy
year.
Holy shit.
Shout out to Steph, year,
Jesus Christ.
5 in 24 and then $59 million in 25.
Moses Moody, you better be that man.
And yeah, they don't even have the projector for him like they have for Dame.
Hell no.
Shit, taxes gonna kill that. That's still hella money, but
yeah, he had no winnings.
Look at his picture. Dog. Look, hella zoomed in.
Yeah, that's a crazy pick. They need another pick.
Okay, hold on. Let me go back one more. So yeah, Dame is 31 now. Steph is what, 34? It said.
Yep. So he's literally on Dame's next extension already.
Yeah. So essentially, I mean, if Portland, because realistically, if Portland's not dumb, if Portland is dumb, when Dame has been in the league for 15 years and is 34 years old, they're going to give him $60 million.
It can't happen. That cannot happen.
It's going
to
happen.
Unless they somehow hit on their picks to the point where it's like, oh, no, yeah, we got it. We got it figured out. We got them peoples in here, which I don't feel like that's going to happen for them.
It's going to happen.
I know football players see like these NBA salaries and be like, man, what the fuck?
Do you ever look at it though, like the how much they make per game though?
NBA players?
No, like when you compare across sports like that, that's how I always think about it. It's like I have to work this many days.
Yeah.
So I make I don't know. Especially with baseball too. Not really for pitchers, because like you're working like every five games or something like that. But like position players, like you're expected to be out there 162 games. Dane's supposed to be out there 82 games plus however many for the playoffs. Football, you're talking about, 17 games if your team doesn't make the playoffs, and then at most 21 games?
Yeah.
So, a lot more work in these other sports, seems like.
It's a lot. A lot of money, but shit, man, that's what these...
It's a lot of money.
That's what these sports do, man.
I'll for sure be looking at a Texas or Florida or Washington team, though. Mm-hmm. If I was a professional athlete, money is no fucking joke.
That's why Tyreek Hill said he didn't go to the Jets.
Yep, because you can't duck the federal tax, so you might as well try to save on the state side.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out all the social programs and shit that benefit from it. But yeah,
Dame right now, just off this year's contract, making basically $500,000 a game, $475,000 a game.
That's fucking crazy, bro.
So if you project that out to the year that he's going to make fucking $60 million a game, which is double what he's making now, or $20 million over what he's making now, he's basically going to be making like $250,000 or $750,000 a game.
Hold on, I got
salute, man.
Whew. I wish I was that nice at anything.
That would be filthy.
Oh, shit.
Okay, so let's see.
Dame's
Jacob agent. DeGrom.
Aaron Goodwin.
Jacob DeGrom signed a 5-year, $185 million contract with the Rangers. He's a pitcher, so he's probably going to get out there, let's say, like 25 times this year at most. But he gets hurt a lot, so it's probably closer to 20. So he's getting over $1 million per appearance.
That's crazy.
Yeah. He's 35 years old. Good. And yeah, he's on the books for another 5 years. So progressively more money.
Shout out to the Mets, man.
That's the Texas Rangers.
I thought he played for the Mets.
He did last year. He signed with the Rangers this offseason.
I can't wait to see what the Mets are going to be playing. Whenever Shohei Ohtani goes to the Mets in 2 years, it makes like $900 million.
This year.
Is it like a foregone conclusion that like Shohei's going to be out of there?
So the problem is,
it doesn't make any sense for him to stay.
Well, it's not even that. Once he gets the open market, it's probably going to be impossible for the Angels to lure him back simply for the fact that they cannot seem to win a fucking game. Like, he can realistically go just across town to the Dodgers and put himself in a way better position while being in the same market. Because, like, one, they'll spend money to be competitive. And two, they do win. It's already Los Angeles. He's already established with Japan. Like, it's not that far. So it's as close as you can get, basically. So that makes a lot more sense. The Dodgers have slowed down on spending money because the people are thinking they're trying to make space for Shohei already.
Yeah.
Like I said, the Angels are just like a wholly uncompetitive fucking franchise.
How are they so bad, though? It don't make sense to me.
It does. Like, so baseball, it doesn't matter if you have like one player who is tremendous. Well, I know
they got two, right? Don't they got like two top four players?
Yeah. They have two top two players.
Oh shit! Okay,
that's craziest thing to say out loud.
And how did them
they have two top four players? They have two top two.
So
players.
One Trout has been more injured the last 2 years than he has been through his entire career.
Okay,
but even if he's out there, like so, baseball they do like wins above replacement WAR. It's a big fucking deal, and Trout is basically worth like on a great year like 10 wins. And it's out of 162 games, like that's not.
Nigga, that's it. The best player's only worth 10 wins.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. It's like because you need pitching, you need consistent defense, and you need consistent bats throughout your lineup. And if Trout is out there and hitting all the dingers that he's hitting, but no one's getting on base in front of him, it doesn't matter. It's one RBI.
Damn. Yeah. I guess. Yeah. I just
same thing with Shohei.
Shohei is making $30 million this year at 28 years old.
So Shohei's going to get out there, and like I said, every 5 nights he's going to throw. He's going to probably give up 2 runs, give your team a good chance to win. But if people can't get on base to score more than 2 runs, then it doesn't matter. It's the same thing that happened to Felix Hernandez. Like same thing's happening to Sandy Alcantara down in on the Marlins right now. He won the Cy Young last year, but they weren't on shit. Like
yeah, we talked about it last week. Where like Shohei was the first player in since 1901 to throw,
to do all that stuff and lose. Yeah,
10 strikeouts, had 10 RBI or 2 RBIs, a hit, a run scored, all this other shit. But it didn't matter because they still lost. Because all it takes is 2 hits.
And that's I guess the part that is confusing, looking from like the outside in at baseball, is that you see all the praise for a player like Mike Trout. And him getting called the GOAT and stuff like that. And it sounds crazy because he hasn't won anything. But baseball is also the sport where your individual performance can very much be captured and isolated out without the team affecting it. So
you can
definitely look at what Mike Trout has done and like and call him that because he's performed at that level. But it again, like it you need the other people on your team to do something, and they just haven't been able to get that going over there. Like, they signed that big-ass deal for Albert Pujols to get him off the Cardinals, and he had, like, 1 good year in Los Angeles. And that was, like, the most money they had given out for a long-ass time, so.
Which is crazy because he played there for 9 years and then went back to St. Louis.
Yeah,
he was on the Angels for 9 years?
Yeah. Damn, he signed with the Angels in 2012, and he went back to the Cardinals last year.
Yeah, but he went to the Dodgers and the Cardinals. They traded him to the Dodgers.
Didn't even realize he went to the Dodgers.
Yep.
I don't think that is.
Baseball is such an unserious sport for reasons like this. Like, I think they said that Ken Griffey Jr. is the third highest paid player on the Cincinnati Reds this season because of how they're paying him out for like the way they cut him or something like that. Like, such an unserious amount of money gets paid out for players that are not playing for teams or players
that are. It's closer. I mean, baseball is more like how soccer is, where there are varying levels of another wages unserious within the sport. Premier League. Some teams spend a lot more money than others, and that's just baseball. Like the damn Pirates are basically like a Triple A team for the Yankees in comparison, like to how much money they spend. Like, but yeah, I mean, I don't know. Like, I'd be surprised if they keep Trout too. The Angels, they just need a lot of fucking rebuilding.
I mean, at this point, they'd kind of be dumb to let him go. Just pay whatever he wants, which he has no reason to leave unless he wants to win.
Yeah, he's competitive as fuck. Like,
is he though?
Absolutely.
What year is he in?
I think he's hitting double digits now.
I'm about to look. Mike Trout was Blake. When's your birthday?
91.
July of 91.
Uh huh.
Mike Trout's a month younger than you.
Mm-hmm.
He's been in the MLB for God damn it! Why didn't it show the years easily? He's been in the MLB since 2011. Since so 12 years, 13 years. He's not going nowhere.
I think he is. The reason he's still on that team is because it takes like 7 years to get to your money. So it's like you don't move those first 7 years. He's had one free agency, but I think they signed him. They gave him his contract before he even hit free agency. It's the same reason Nakam Tatis got paid already, the same reason that Julio got paid already. Okay. So they lock you up beyond when you hit free agency, and then that way you hit free agency like at 34 or some shit like that. There's less offers for you at that point. They've already got your best years from you. Yeah, baseball's contract situation is nasty. They get a lot of wild. Fucking money, but teams absolutely suck you fucking dry before you get a chance to really get your value.
Blake, when do you think Mike Trout's a free agent?
Never.
What year?
2032.
2031. Okay. Yeah, this nigga signed a 12-year contract in 2019.
Yep. Damn.
That's how I think Julio signed like a 12 or 15 or something like that.
He signed a 14-year contract.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Tatis signed like a 10 or something too.
Yeah, Tatis signed a 10 because I'm used to the like 10-year, $420 million contract or 4-year. Mm-hmm. 320 or something like that, and Julio signed a 14-year. Mike Trout signed a 12-year contract when he was 27 years old. He's not going anywhere, buddy.
Because the way teams look at it is like if we're taking away, I think you have four arbitration years, four or three arbitration years, and you have 3 years where the team basically can determine your salary. They can say exactly what they're going to pay you, and that's it before you even get eligible for arbitration. So there's a 7-year window of times where you are salary controlled, and then after that you get free agency. So if they sign you like in year two of that 7-year window, they've effectively taken away, what is that, 5 years of you bargaining and then 5 years of you being free. So
yeah, Julio Rodriguez for the Mariners signed a 12-year, $209 million contract in 2022. Yeah. So he signed through 2035.
And he would be probably the MVP favorite.
There's a club option in 2030.
If Shohei exists.
Yeah, he's 100% doing a favor. Shohei's about to get $1 billion, I think. Like,
I think half a billion.
Shohei's about to go to some. Shohei's about to go to like the Dodgers or the fucking Padres or some team who likes throwing him. I still keep thinking the Mets. They're about to pay him a ridiculous amount of money.
Or I could see the Yankees too because he already doesn't have facial hair. So
we don't got to pay him to shave his face. He's good. Mm-hmm. Wow.
They be paying people to shave their face?
No, you just have to shave your face to be on the team. They don't pay
not
you.
Not allowed to have facial hair. Man. They got to be throwing a little extra money in there. I know Derek Jeter, if he had a beard, he would have the bitches.
And he don't even have one now, I don't think.
Yeah, of course, because he's had 25 years of not having a beard.
Hmm. Oh, could he have extra? Like,
yes,
he was out here.
Yes, if there was more bitches to be had, he would have had them.
I don't know, he had them all.
There was more.
There's always more.
There's always more, as Jamal knows.
All right,
what's wrong, Mr. Bitches?
That's crazy. Look at these narratives. But I'm going to check the score on the game. I know I saw that they were up 12 at the half, Connecticut. Oh, Blake, you had said, where did you see? You saw the Lakers were plus 3,300?
That's what Fox Sports 1 said earlier today.
Shit, I'm on MGM right now. They're plus 1,700 to win it all, and then plus 800 to win the West. The Lakers.
I wonder who the Fox Sports 1 uses for the bet representation.
Yeah, I wonder what sportsbook
they use. That's double.
They use Fox Bets. They have their own like book.
Oh, shit, for real?
How do I get the Fox Bet?
You got to go to their headquarters.
Hey, speaking of bets, did both of you guys watch Snowfall this week?
Yes.
Yeah.
How does Franklin get out of this season? Spoilers.
Dead.
Does Franklin survive?
Hope not. Fuck him.
Dog, Louis looked him in the face and said, you know you're the devil, right? And he's like, I know, but I need your help.
I hope they all die. Honestly, hope it's just a fucking plane crash. Take them all out. Evil ass fucking people.
Yeah. I feel like Franklin's mom about to kill herself.
Yeah, she just basically said her husband's dead, even though I think he just had like a contract dispute, so he's not on the show.
That's funny.
That motherfucker's alive and well.
I just want Teddy to get killed. Teddy get killed, I'm good.
He could be flying the plane that they all die on. I don't care. They all need to go.
Honestly, Blake's right. I agree with you, Blake. Honestly, everybody in the same place. Jerome is the one person I wanted to survive. No, fuck Leon. Not
Leon.
Fuck
trash Leon. Too. He wore a fucking daishiki twice and now he's good. Come on, bro.
He tried to leave everything behind him and expand his horizon.
He let people tell him about Africa. Yeah. He didn't even learn that shit from an African. You learned that shit.
He didn't try to leave everything behind. He left everything behind for 45 minutes of a show and then came back home and it was like, ooh.
He's sitting in a fucking garden with Avi doing LSD talking about Ghana. Like, come on, bro. Fuck out of here.
Ain't nobody else on. So you got Leon.
Dude went and saw the promise and came back to start pushing poison again in the projects.
Damn.
He's fucking corny. No, he really got it. Nah.
And Leon's been looking beat up for 5 episodes while Big D has been fine. The whole
time. Yo, you about to get his rematch.
That coat Big D had on, like that a flannel overcoat, nigga? I've never seen no jacket like
crazy.
It was crazy.
It was. Wow. That shit was hard.
it was kind of hard. I ain't gonna lie.
That shit was hard. Big D got some drip on him, honestly.
Pause.
Hey, I hate calling anything that. I don't know his real name.
Yeah, that's crazy. Big D got some drip on him.
I don't know his real name.
Hey, you have some crazy shit, Jamal?
What?
Like Lita and Trish Stratus are like just back as near semi-regular members of Raw now.
Dude, what year is it, man? I seen everybody tweeting like Lita needs to hang it the fuck up. Cooper saying she look kind of old.
Yeah. Oh, it's O'Shea Jackson in the crowd. Wow. But yeah, no, it ain't doing what it's supposed to do.
Lita was nice, man. She was fucking cold.
Hall of Famer, bro. She's out here.
Yeah. She was doing all the Hardy Boy shit, honestly.
I mean, not all, but
not all of it, but like, you know, like
she would do as much as Matt did.
Wasn't
nobody doing all of what Jeff did.
Do you think everybody's favorite was Jeff? Like, do you think one person like Matt Absolutely. More than Jeff?
There's no way. The leg drop?
Yeah, the Swanton Bomb, yeah.
Come on, bro.
That's crazy. That's got to suck being like, I guess you learned
like Edge and Christian.
It doesn't have to suck.
No, you know what? Brother. I've heard of people saying they like Christian more. I've heard people say he's a better technical wrestler.
No, you didn't.
I'm telling you, I've heard people say that on like Twitter.
I feel like oh my god, he's so technical. It's a fucking spear, bro. Look at this.
I feel like for Matt and Jeff, there's just the other brother, and you grow up. I'm perfectly accepting of the fact that people are aware that they're the other brother. You're the other sibling. Like
the one fair split, like where I could hear the argument either way, would be the Dudley boys. Like okay, like. Matter of fact, no. I feel like Bubba Ray probably is a better solo wrestler.
Yeah. And one of them is black.
I can't even lie and say D-Von was my favorite.
Shout out to D-Von, though, because they was great together. But, yeah, nah. Like, oh, he had that gimmick afterwards. It just wasn't doing it the same way. Bubba Ray was a fucking factor.
Hey, Bubba was fucking cold, man. they used to beat up the women like if you had your manager out there with you back in the day, like yo, they're finna put her through a table.
And they put Stacy Keebler in the Hall of Fame this past weekend.
Oh, nice.
Yep, she's out there looking. We're old. That's all I'm gonna say. We are aged,
dude. We're I feel seasoned. Like out of all like the divas back there, I feel like she was like my least favorite, probably out of all of them. Maybe
she did the least wrestling.
Yeah, it's probably because like everybody liked Trish more. There was Sable.
Trish had a dope ass finisher too.
Wasn't it just a fucking kick?
Turnbuckle.
What did she do off the turnbuckle?
The run it was like Spike Dudley's where he had
you know, oh, kind of like the bulldog off the
yeah. Yep.
I barely remember that.
That shit was tough. Stratisfaction.
Damn. It was called that, huh? Damn, look, you got a good ass memory.
She was probably a SmackDown wrestler, is why. What I had.
Oh yeah, you said you didn't watch Raw growing up. Mm-hmm. Yeah, nah, man, damn, I can't believe they're back now, dude. They had the little comic book convention in Puyallup last year. They had Sergeant Slaughter there, the nigga that created the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. What's his name? Jason David Frank, the dude, the Green Ranger that passed away last year.
R.I.P.
And then Trish Stratus was there, And I definitely almost went by. I did not feel like driving all the way to Puyallup.
Every time I hear her name, look, I get the soundbite of King saying, "The puppies, the puppies." Nasty asshole, man.
Yeah, no, he's bury him under the. No, deep. I didn't know. Cause people be shitting on him all the time. You remember the dude that was in that stable with Rikishi and Scotty Tuhati, Grandmaster Sexy?
He said it was his son, right? And he had, like,
yeah,
he
that's
was
his son. Drug issues
the was... least memorable person of that group.
Yeah, he killed himself. He hung himself.
Oh,
yeah.
Wish he would have led with that. That's crazy.
Yeah, nah, he's out of here.
Because Scotty Tuhati had the worm. Rikishi was putting his ass in niggas' faces. Very memorable.
Mm-hmm. That's kind of a sus gimmick. Like, how you getting agreed? Like, I don't know. Like, I'm not letting a man put his ass like die. Like,
me neither, but I'm also not hanging myself. So,
all right.
This one.
Scotty Tuhati's like a firefighter in Florida now. I read that online.
He's been a firefighter for like 40 years at this
probably
point.
A long ass time, man.
It's been a long time.
Yeah. Nah, man. Shout out to wrestling, man. When Vince McMahon when it's his untimely demise, and you know he goes to goes down there. Because we know he's going down there. He's a terrible person, but
all of
I'm
us.
Definitely
who's going down there.
Vince McMahon.
We're all going there.
You think Vince McMahon is seeing heaven?
He has a dinosaur skull in his office, so I don't know.
Yeah, he's definitely not going to heaven just off of that. But yeah, no, I'll pour out a little liquor for him with Vince pass.
Pussy. Hey Blake, is this your last episode in North Carolina?
Yeah.
Wow. Hey, shout out to you. Shout out to the time difference. Shout out to racism. All of it. Well, really not racism. What it was. That's going to carry over.
What are you going to miss the most about NC?
What am I going to miss the most about North Carolina?
Going to J. Cole's house.
No, I only did that like twice.
It's crazy.
Damn, what am I going to miss more about North Carolina? What do we got down here that's like just dope?
I could ask barbecue, right?
Yeah, it's okay.
He only ate meat for like 6 months.
A year. Yeah. I think it was pretty cool that every restaurant has sweet tea. Simple.
Okay.
Yeah. Just an option. Literally. Oh, Bojangles. So I'll miss Bojangles. I know I'm never gonna have that again, probably.
I've heard
that's only in the South, right?
I've heard very good things about Bojangles.
Yeah.
I think it's only like in the Southeast, like Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, not even the whole South, but like that specific like area of the South.
Bojangles is fire. I'm gonna miss them. The fries is smacking.
Hey man. I'm
breakfast all day if you want it.
I'm happy I never had to go to North Carolina to see you. I'm happy you're going to be closer to us. We're going to take a couple weeks off before we get to the 100th episode, as this is episode 99. So you will see us as much more mature men.
I think both of y'all would really enjoy living in North Carolina, though, honestly. Like I know like price of living up there is like kicking everybody's ass, but you could live pretty comfortable down here. And I mean, it is a change of culture from Washington, especially if you're in a place like I'm in down here in Fayetteville. But if you like are living up in the Triangle, like where the schools are, like Raleigh, Wake Forest, Chapel Hill, that type of area, it's a lot more, I'll say, left leaning and accepting and all those type of things. But even where I am here in Cumberland County. As conservative as it is, folks don't like really, I don't know, they don't go out their way to make you not feel comfortable. Everybody is very welcoming, and like if you talk to anybody, people tend to be like extremely nice and helpful and shit like that. It's just, yeah, the bumper stickers on cars are different. That's it. But I never had no bad situation down here. I can say that for myself. And I've been, I don't know, all over this bitch, to different rural places completely by myself. Inside folks' houses that I've never met before, just because like I have to do business with them, and everybody's been like more than welcoming. So I definitely have enjoyed that down here. I definitely enjoy going in places, and like when you walk in, if somebody's right there and they look and see you, they say hi and you say hi back and you just keep moving on. Like it's like people acknowledge you. That shit's cool. Mm-hmm.
gonna miss that. Yeah, and living around this many black people too. That's also been a stark change from anything else I've experienced in life, to have like basically a majority black city that I live in.
I'm very jealous of that.
Pretty cool. So
that shit's a shock. The first time you go somewhere like that.
Yeah, I mean, this isn't the first time I've been somewhere. It's just I live here now.
Yeah, so, and you live there. Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. So I'll miss that, but most of my life hasn't been this way. So it's not nothing that won't be hard to get used to. Just yeah, going places and seeing other black people and not doing a head nod because it's not rare. We're everywhere.
Well, with that being said, I'm glad you're going to one of the whitest places on the planet.
Yeah, but I've had a good time in Colorado Springs. Short amount of time that I've been there. Looking forward to building new experiences there. Obviously, very different from here. So,
honestly, I'm just happy.
Honestly, tired of this fucking place, so I can't wait to get out of here.
Yeah, I'm happy that you're closer to us. We can link up. We don't got to start the podcast at an hour where you're about to fall asleep every week.
Yeah,
me and you can golf together.
If y'all are feeling like you've tapped out of your potential up there, though, I would definitely look into moving to the Southeast if I was you guys. There's definitely lots of opportunity to grow and build yourself out as, I guess, like financially and everything. Obviously, if your path to buying a house, owning property, building that generational wealth and equity and shit like that, it's a lot easier down here than it is where you are.
So fucking expensive out here, bro.
Yeah. So,
but this is where the money's at.
It all depends. I mean, if you do tech, the money's down here too. It's everyone else coming down here.
Good point.
Yeah. If you do work for the federal government, the money's down here too. It's the same money.
This is true. This is true.
Yeah.
How many years were you down there? Or how many years you been there now?
2018. So
2018? Okay.
Yeah. Four and some change.
Damn. Hey, man, it's going to be dope to have you back in the same time zone, man.
Close to one. I'm one over
an hour ahead.
Yeah. Oh, what? They're not in the same time zone as us?
Nah, they're.
Yeah. Oh my god, dude!
Oh, I didn't know that.
But it's close enough. This is the closest we're gonna have you since 2014, I think, when you moved to Germany, which is ideal. And again, you're 2.5-3 hour flight away.
Yeah.
We will be pulling up. Me and Tyler, we gonna make that drive. The mountains. Oh.
Don't drive.
No, we driving.
We're not driving, but we're about to fly. Driving. And we're about to act up. I hope Bree puts all the guns away, because we're about to act up.
It's like $130 from SeaTac to Denver. You just drive an hour south.
Yeah, we're acting up.
Oh, yeah, fuck that. Yeah, there's no
point. Can't wait. All right, well, we'll see y'all in a couple weeks. This is episode 99 of the Critically Unfocused Podcast. 99. Episode 100 is coming when it comes. Okay.
Pause.
You didn't have to do that. Episode 100 is coming when it comes. We will be here. We will be back. We might have a guest or two. Oh.
Hey, YouTube, remember? Yeah, it's the MJ. MJ gonna get us. It's a state.
What money you gonna take?
This is true.
Can we go out on that? Play that again. So we can go out on that. That was hard. I like that.
That is a great beat.
Yeah. Hey.
Might be the best album ever, honestly. Off the wall.
The Thriller didn't exist. All right, 99, we out, man.
We out of here.